Friends, it's great to see you back this week. We have a really interesting story to share with you today, and I can't wait to unpack it with you. Have you ever read or heard something that was confusing? Maybe your teacher was explaining a new topic that didn't make sense, or you were in dance class having a hard time learning a new technique. In our lives, we experience things that don't make sense. Sometimes that happens with the Bible too. We can read things that we don't quite understand. That's why we need the Holy Spirit to give us wisdom while we read. He will help us know what God's Word says and why we need to know it. But before we go and discuss what God's Word is and why we need the Holy Spirit, let's all get up on our feet and get ready to worship our God. Ready? Count down with me. 3, 2, 1, hit it!
There is only one, there is only one, there is only one Lord. Tell me that you're pleased and that I'm
I love to worship. Worship always prepares my heart to receive the lesson of the day, and today's lesson is so good. But first, let's go over our ICC Kids values. Our first value is love God. We love God because He loved us first. Our second value is love people. We love people because God loves all people. Our third value is have fun. We have fun because God gives us joy. Our fourth and last value is make a difference. We make a difference because Jesus did. Great job, everyone. One thing we can do to move towards loving God is to pray and learn about the Bible. If you have your Bible with you today, hold it up so we can see. The Bible is God's word. It tells us the wonderful story of God's plan to rescue sinners. That reminds me of the big picture question we have been answering. Who is in control? We know that God is in control of everything in heaven and on earth. Nothing is outside of God's good plan. I'm so glad the answer to that question isn't me. Can you imagine if you or I were in control over everything? We would surely mess it all up. But God doesn't make mistakes. God is perfect in everything He does and is never surprised by the things that happen in life. Our key passage comes from the book of Psalms. The word psalm means song. So this book contains worship songs to be sung to God. Just like lots of songs that are written today, the Psalms express a wide range of emotions. Sometimes the writer was sad and expressed his grief or mourning to God. Our key passage comes from Psalm 135, which contains reminders of all that God has done for His people. In remembering God's faithfulness, the writer, he praises God. Let's say our memory verse together. I know that the Lord is great, that our Lord is greater than all gods. The Lord does whatever pleases Him in the heavens and on the earth, in the seas and all their depths. Psalm 135, 5-6. Abraham was certainly surprised by God many times. We've learned that God spoke to Abraham and called him to pack up his whole family and move to a new land. God promised to give Abraham a large family, even though he was old and didn't have any children. God also said He would give Abraham's descendants that land that he had moved to. God would bless the whole world through Abraham's family. Now all Abraham had to do was wait for God to keep that promise.
God kept His promise to give Abraham a son. Abraham and his wife Sarah were very old when their son Isaac was born. One day, God tested Abraham. He wanted to make sure that Abraham loved God most of all. Abraham, God said. Here I am, Abraham answered. Take your son Isaac to the mountain and give him to me as a sacrifice, God said. Abraham obeyed God. He got up early the next day and left with Isaac, two servants, and a donkey carrying supplies. They walked for 3 days before they got to the mountain where God wanted Abraham to make the sacrifice. Abraham asked his servants to stay with the donkey. We'll be back, he said. Then he and Isaac went up the mountain with the supplies for the sacrifice. Isaac saw that something was missing. My father, he said, where is the lamb for the offering? Abraham answered, God Himself will provide the lamb. When they got to the place God had directed them, Abraham built an altar and placed the wood on top. Then he put Isaac on top of the wood. Just as Abraham was about to sacrifice Isaac, the angel of the Lord called out, Abraham, Abraham! Abraham stopped. Here I am, he said. The angel of the Lord said, do not lay a hand on the boy or do anything to him. For now I know that you fear God, since you have not withheld your only son from me. Abraham looked up and saw a ram trapped by its horns in the bushes. He offered the ram to God instead of Isaac. Abraham named the place, The Lord Will Provide. The angel of the Lord reminded Abraham that God would keep the covenant he made with Abraham. God again promised to bless Abraham, to make his family as numerous as all the stars in the sky and the sand on the seashores. God promised victory over Abraham's enemies and blessings to all the earth through Abraham's family. Abraham showed his love for God by being willing to sacrifice his son Isaac. God provided a ram instead. This is how God showed his love for us. He sent his son Jesus to die on the cross so that we could have eternal life through him.
Sometimes stories in the Bible are hard to understand. It may be difficult for us to understand why God told Abraham to sacrifice Isaac. God does not call for human sacrifice, but in this story, God told Abraham to offer Isaac as a means of testing Abraham's faith. Let's take a look at three important things we can take away from this story. First, this story shows that God provides the greater sacrifice. God never intended for Abraham to sacrifice his son. He told Abraham to do this as a means of testing and growing his faith. Abraham didn't waver. He was ready to obey God. On the way up the mountain, Isaac noticed that they didn't have what was needed for the sacrifice. Abraham told him that God himself would provide. Just like God provided the ram for Abraham to sacrifice, God provided the ultimate sacrifice for our sin. God called Abraham to offer his son, but instead, God gave up his one and only son on our behalf. Second, we learn that God knows what is best for us. The Lord has something to teach Abraham in this story. Abraham may have been tempted to love his son Isaac more than he loved God, but God had something better in store for Abraham. God wanted Abraham's faith to grow and for Abraham's love for God to go even deeper. God wants the same for us. Are there things in your life that you are tempted to love more than God? Those things may not be bad things, but if anything becomes an idol in our hearts, it becomes bad for us. God wants what is best for us, and that is Himself. God wants us to know and to love Him, to trust and obey Him alone. Third, we see that God always keeps His promises. When Abraham demonstrated his great faith and love for God, God reminded Abraham again of his promise. God promised Abraham that he would make his descendants as numerous as the sand on the seashore, and that one day his family would take possession of the special land that God would give them. God also reminded Abraham of his promise to bless all the nations of the world through his descendants. Abraham showed his love for God by being willing to sacrifice his son Isaac. God provided a ram instead. This is how God showed his love for us. He sent his son, Jesus, to die on the cross so that we could have eternal life through him. Let's pray together. Father, we are so thankful that we have your word and can know you through these words. You are wonderful, and we want to praise you for all that you have done for us. Give us thankful hearts this week. Help us to love you more than anything else. Amen. Amen. Thank you all so much for joining us today. We'll see you next week. Bye.